got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling.
Speak into the microphone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Make sure
you get there. There we go. Jill, when we each began our search for love, it started with a few keystrokes and a couple clicks of a mouse. Neither of us knew what was going to happen in the search. But luckily, we were brave enough to give fate a chance. The internet and fate got us together, but God has brought us here today. His presence in our lives has nurtured us, and it's nurtured our love for each other and strengthened our commitment and trust. Over the course of our relationship, I have fallen in love with you over and over again. These falls didn't hurt nearly as bad as the couple that I took when we were in Colorado the night I proposed. But I wouldn't trade any of it for the world. I never want to stop falling in love with you. Jill, you are my best friend, my partner, and my everything. I truly believe the best thing about me is you. For this and every other reason, these have been the happiest 2 years of my life. I pledge my love to you now until the end of our days.
Ooh.
Got to go first.
Did it take a minute? Okay. Ryan, 3 years ago, I used these exact words, some online source, to describe my ideal man. Quote, "My ideal man would be kind, confident, hardworking, and a people person. I want a man that I can laugh with and work on projects with." "I want someone who challenges me and supports me along the way. My mate has to enjoy traveling and an active lifestyle. If you are listening carefully, which you do, you probably realize that I just described you. Ryan, you are my dream man. You are my passionate farmer, hardworking carpenter, food garbage disposal, partner in activity, but most of all, you are my best friend. Looking back, I remember many moments that made me fall in love with you and ultimately brought us to this day. Here are just a few. After just 3 dates, I went to visit my sister in Colorado. You were home farming and called me from the combine, but I could hear the excitement and the pride in your voice. That was the day that I fell in love with your passion. Once I accepted my new teaching position in Northport, I needed to drive up and find housing. You decided to come with me. Being on third shift, that meant that you would not sleep for over 24 hours, but you wanted to come anyway. That was the day I fell in love with your commitment. During our first fall in Northport, there was an unusually warm October evening, and we thought it would be great to go swimming in the freezing cold Lake Michigan. But that was the day I fell in love with your fun-loving, adventurous spirit. Oh, that was cold.
I think that might have been November.
Yeah, November. It was cold. December was your first skiing adventure. You knew there were pretty high stakes, considering my passion or so-called obsession for it.
I'd say obsession.
I have to say, you weren't the easiest student. You couldn't understand after why just 2 runs down the hill you hadn't picked it up as well as the pros. However, that was the day I fell in love with your determination. At some point in the early in that first year, I remember the realization of, oh my goodness, I just moved away from the man I love. What are we gonna do? Later that year, you made the ultimate sacrifice. I'm good. You left your job that you loved to start a life with me. That was when I knew that you were in it forever. Ryan, you are my dream man. I love your passion. I love your commitment, fun-loving spirit, and determination. I look forward to a marriage with you filled with laughter, adventure, family, and lots of hugs and kisses. I love you today and for always. What do you have, Kleenex?
You don't have any?
That didn't need to go on the mic. We're okay. Thank you.
I hate you so much. I did.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Yeah.
Okay. You're first. Okay. And if you repeat after me to Jill. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Ryan, take you, Jill.
I, Ryan, take you, Jill.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Oh boy.
If you'd repeat after me to Ryan. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Jill, take you, Ryan.
I, Jill, take you, Ryan.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Now that Jill and Ryan have given themselves to each other by solemn vows with the joining of hands, the giving and receiving rings, and the pouring of sand, I announce to you that they are husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. The traditional thing for you to do is give each other a kiss. So why don't you do that? My privilege to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jill and Ryan Vigenski.
Thank you.
Would you greet them?
All right.